My relations, my relatives, I am Lord Stanley. I am the Episcopal priest who serves on the Rosebud Reservation in South Dakota. We are your partners, and you are our partners. In God's mission in this world, and especially in that place which makes us relatives, who have been joined together by God, and for probably the only time in my life, I can stand before you today and I can say with real feeling, thank God for the Zika virus. Because if Zika hadn't hit South and Central America with a vengeance last year, your mission team would have gone to Costa Rica. We would have come to the Rosebud. And if your team had not come to the Rosebud, then we would not have met then, and we would not be relatives now, and we wouldn't be together too. So I'm saying, you know, thank God for the Zika virus. Today, I welcome you as the preacher to the most mislabeled Sunday in the entire church here. And I'm not talking about this being Low Sunday, because guess what? We just hit the national number 40. Just to let you know, this isn't Low Sunday. But that's the Sunday when people are like, oh, we can't go to church because, you know, Easter. Easter. We're going to take a day off. No. This is the Sunday that we call Doubting Thomas Sunday. Because this Sunday in the church here, every single church here, doesn't matter ABC or what, you get to hear this story, the story you know so well of Doubting Thomas. Well, there's only one problem with that. Nowhere in John's gospel, nowhere does John say that Thomas doubted. The word disazo is just not there. It's in Matthew's gospel. But this is John's gospel. And John doesn't say that Thomas is doubting. John is telling us that Thomas has questions. And Thomas has a contract. And Thomas wants an answer. He wants his contract fulfilled before he falls headfirst again into that life-changing faith that had made everything in his world different. He had left everything he had. He had traveled with Jesus. He had seen miracles, fed the people, watched Lazarus raised from the dead. He had even promised to go with Jesus back to heaven after Lazarus died. It's Thomas who said, well, let's all go with him so that we can die. This is not a man that doubted just because he wasn't in the upper room. This is a man who laid out some conditions. If I see this, then I will believe that. If this happens, then I will do that. That's not doubt. That's a man who wants a contract with God because he thinks God's broken a contract with him. That's what's going on in today's gospel. Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, the one they waited 2,000 years for. And he died on the cross. Like a common criminal. Want me to believe he's raised from the dead, Lord, you and everyone better show up and prove to me you are who you say you are. Because I am not going down that path again. I gave everything to you and you took it away. You want me back? You got these. It's a contract, people. It's not a doubt. It's just a plain old contract. I gotta know that in the Greek, the if then is actually done in the negative. That's a detail on the end of the conversation. We can have that later. Because I know that I'm having that conversation. Beth and I are going to have that conversation, but we've already determined that. But what it came down to was this. There was no way, none whatsoever, that Thomas was going to fall for some continental story and risk his entire life, his soul, unless Jesus met some conditions. You show up. You let me put my hand in your side. You proved to me you are the one I loved and believed in and followed and gave everything in my life for. And then, well, then I'll be fine. I'll move on with it. It's the same thing we all do. It doesn't make it any different. We all do this contractual negotiating with God every single day. If God will do this, I will do that. If God will show me a sign, I will believe. If God will heal, I'm going to kill myself on this thing over here in this fire extinguisher. If God will heal my friend, I will go off and save the world. If God this, if God, we do it all the time. In the business world, I believe we call it a return on investment. It's an ROI. If I put my money in, I want to see it come out, I want to see a certain result. That's how the world works. That's what we do all the time, whether we need to or not. And we actually try to hold God to the same standard, an ROI, a return on investment. I will give my whole life to you, Lord, but you need to give me something. And if you're not going to give me something, I'm not going to do this, Lord. But what it comes down to with Thomas is he needs to learn to trust again. His trust was broken. And he needs to learn to trust again. And it's the same thing that we need to learn to do. We need to learn to just trust God. Because God trusts us. We need to have faith in God because God has faith in us. If God didn't have faith in us, we wouldn't be here today. We literally would not be sitting in church with a man. But I know how the world works. I know that it's very difficult sometimes to figure out where we're going to put our time and our energy. I know it's hard for us to be able to believe. And I know that we live in turbulent times. Now listen, I'm going to tell you this right here and now. I am not talking about politics. I do not care for whom you voted. I do not care what you did. The fact of the matter is we live in turbulent times. And we have to decide that we are going to trust God get us through these times, and that God is going to tell us what we need to do, and then we need to go do it. That's all there is to it. God has faith in us to calm these times down, and it isn't coming upon us. It's not coming on some other people down the road. It's us. Now I know what y'all want a little bit of, because you're human beings, and because why should you trust me? I'm just a preacher from the post. You all don't know very much about it. So I brought you some proof. Y'all know what this is? This, my friends, is a piece of cottonwood. This is a piece of wood that came out of a tree that was 200 years old. And it had died. And the school district in Dakota County decided that we were going to get this wood because we are the ones who provide firewood to the others. This piece of wood. Now, what do y'all know about cottonwood? Y'all know anything about cottonwood? As a real deep fabric. It can go anywhere. And it'll go sideways and up and down. It's incredible to look at to find water. That's how we find water on reds. We just look for our cottonwoods. We live on the high plains. We don't have a lot of trees. You can see for miles. We have open skies. And then you'll see a few little trees here and there. And they're all cottonwood. And that's where we know there's water. But when the cottonwood dies and the water leaves it, it turns into a rock. It is solid. It takes forever to split. Last year when your team came out, we joined with another team and we put 15 girls out there. They chose the piece of wood. Now I'm telling you, I've never known who had picked that piece of wood. Because it had a great big knot in the middle of it. You do not split a piece of wood with a knot in it with an axe or a sledgehammer. You should step on it. But the girls had started by the time. So we got a bunch of girls over there, and they're trying to split a piece of wood, and I got a bunch of guys over here sitting around going, "Can't do it. It can't be done." So I went and gathered all the girls. We got 15 of us all together, and I said, "Ladies, let's have a litter. Say this can't be done." Nothing changed. It took us 5 hours. It took 15 of us. We each took turns taking 10 whacks at a time, and we split that piece of wood. That's how hard it got to work. So we're out there, we're splitting wood for our fireworks for the other firework for the elder program, and Matt takes a look at me and he says, "You need a bigger splitter, because we have a wood splitter. It's a 7-ton electric runway. And we call it Tinkerbell. Because it's little. All of our toys have names. All of them." And he says, "You need a bigger splitter." And I said, "We don't have the money." And he said, "That's not the issue." So we looked it up online. We stood out there at the wood cutting site. We looked it up online. And he said, "Where do you look?" I said, WoodSplitterDirect.com. That's right. Who knew there was a company called that? And you all bought us a splitter, but it didn't arrive before you went. that we had, our winter started in October, like October 2nd, with our first snowfall, and the first time that the temperatures plummeted down to zero. Because of you, now one person on the Rosebud phrase for that this year. Do you see what you're doing? Do you see how by being involved with us and by making a general donation, you have made it possible to keep people alive? If you want a return on investment, that piece of wood, that's going to go alive right there. That's what we do in the church. That's what we relatives are doing in the church. You all are making it possible for all of your relatives on the Rosebud to literally stay alive. That is what Jesus is asking of Thomas when Thomas shows up again and Jesus shows up again. He's not asking him to just believe. He's asking him to live his belief. He's saying, trust me. Don't worry about this contract on self. Just trust me. And then go do. And that is what today is really about. It's really about trusting and then taking that trust and putting it into action. Because that is what we are called to do. My brothers and sisters, we are not called to sit here and have a contractual discussion with God. Now, I am aware that I am in Southport, Connecticut, which is part of Fairfield, which is part of the South Coast of Connecticut, which is very close to New York, and there are a lot of people who work in the legal profession. I am well aware of where I am, okay? I am well aware that you all do business contracts. That you all are businessmen and businesswomen, that you all are involved in big money. I know what you do, and I am telling you, do not buy that car! Because that is not what God is calling you to do. This is not about contract, this is about trust. This is about faith. And it's not about your faith in God. I'm sorry, God's faith in man. This is about God's faith in you. About God's faith in you to go into the world and among other things to keep my faith.